Hi guys, how are you? It is time for tea time. Time for Marcel Riemer's book review. I have my black tea latte here, very yummy. And I hope so do you. Hope you have your appropriate beverage handy Sunday afternoon, the best time to have a tea, whatever beverage you prefer. And it's time for a nice little book review. So today I have picked this book, John Maxwell, Failing Forward. Of course, this is a book I have read and I highly recommend. I think most of you know John Maxwell. He is a motivational speaker. He is a public speaker. He's very, very famous. I have read a lot of books of him. I have plenty of books here. He is very inspirational. He's very famous. He's from the United States, as most of you probably know. And I picked this book because, you know, this topic of failure and mistakes, this is it's a big topic. There are plenty of books written about this topic. It's a very sensitive issue. Definitely this book will help you to work, to get to work on your mindset. It helped me, yeah. And that's why and therefore I recommend it to you to read it. It's not a big book, you know. It's easy to read. John Maxwell, by the way, all the books he writes are very easy to read. Yeah, they are not a different read. They're very easy to read. I like the style he writes his books, and they're full of stories. He is putting a lot of stories into his books. So. And as usually, I have prepared a few quotes here from this book. I try to compress it as much as I can. As I say, my reviews are just here to serve you as an appetizer. I want to make you hungry to read the book yourself. I'm not reviewing the whole thing. I will not reveal everything what's written. I just give you what I see, what I perceive as the highlights, what I find the highlights are. And then it's up to you to go to the bookshop and buy the book, purchase the book, or you download it on Audible or whatever. So, Failing Forward. So I want to start with a nice quote from the book. Life is not simply holding a good hand. Life is playing a poor hand as well. That's a Danish saying. I have that from the book, and I really like that quote. Life is not simply holding a good hand. Life is playing a poor hand as well, which is true. You know, because not every time or everything in life is going according to our wish and will and according to our plan. We all know this. I don't need to tell you this. That's why this book, you know. The difference between average people and achieving people is their perception of and response to failure. This is also a quote from the book. The difference between average people and achieving people is their perception of and response to failure. So it's all about how you respond, how able are you to respond to circumstances, peoples and events. I think we talked about this in the last review a little bit when I had Ego is the Enemy of Ryan Holiday here. Putting a new face on failure. This is a similar statement from the book, putting a new face on failure. So it's really how do what kind of attitude are you dealing with these circumstances? Failure is not avoidable. It's not. This is... I think one of the first quotes in the book which struck me, failure is not available. So make no mistake. In that case, yeah, please make no mistakes. We all need to make mistakes. I know mistakes are important, but in that case, please make no mistake about that. Yeah, failure is not avoidable. You will learn lessons during your life. There are no mistakes, only lessons. A lesson is repeated until it's learned. If you don't learn easy lessons, they get harder. And you will know you have learned your lesson when your actions changes. These are 5 points from the book. Yeah, which John is pointing out here. So he is seeing mistakes rather lessons than mistakes. You know, it is really a perspective thing here. Yeah, it sounds very easy. Conceptually, it might be very easy, but practically, we all know it's not easy to view mistakes as lessons. Intellectually, yes, we understand. Oh yeah, okay, mistakes. Oh, I did a mistake. Oh, I know mistakes we have to make and this and that. But you know, practically, you know, we are afraid to make mistakes because we were conditioned to do like this since childhood. So let's keep moving. The book continues. Failure is not an event. It's how you deal with life along the way. Failure is an inside job. It's not what happens to me. It's what happens in me. You know, this is so, so true. I really like that statement. It goes very deep. That goes along and together with the other points I mentioned already. Failure is not an event. It is how you deal with life along the way. It's really true. I already mentioned our responsibility, or actually what I like more. I don't like the word responsibility too much because it is not really saying what it's not really conveying and saying what it really means. It's rather the responsibility is rather the ability to respond appropriately and properly. And that is so true with many, many things in our life, also in regards to failure. Failure is not our enemy. It's not our enemy. People who don't give up keep trying because they don't base their self-worth on their performance. Also very important. Yeah, they're not identified with that. People who don't give up keep trying because they don't base their self-worth on the performance. So yeah, when you screw it up, you know, you failed or you missed the target or whatever, we are so much identified with that, right? And then we consider ourselves as failure, which is not the right thing to do. You know, if your self-worth has nothing to do with that, the book is explaining this very well. Take responsibilities for your action, but don't take failure personally. It's another one. Again, that goes together with the point I just mentioned earlier. Just do it. If you fail, do it again. Yeah, these are just some quotes from the book. All these points I'm covering here are actually worth separate videos because they are really deep. They are really truthful. Like I say, I'm just quoting here. I want to wake up your appetite a little bit. 90% of those who fail are not defeated, actually. They just quit. Another thing to think about, right? But it's actually true, right? We quit. And then once you quit, once you stopped, then you failed, basically. So failure is all in your hands, basically. You decide what becomes a failure or what not. So the book shows you altogether 14 steps how to fail forward, how to get over yourself, how to start adding value to other people, how to embrace failure as a friend. Yeah, that sounds crazy, huh? But it is possible. You can read this in the book, how to embrace failure as a friend. To avoid, the book also shows you how to avoid the top 10 reasons why people fail. For example, because of impatience. You are impatient, or you have no goals, or you're doing shortcuts, you know. This is, I think, one major reason that most of us are very, very impatient. I know what I'm talking about. I am by nature a very impatient person, and this is certainly one big reason if you fail along the way. And I will definitely agree with John Maxwell here. The top 10 ways people get in their own way, and to understand that there is not much difference between failure and success. So the book, again, will show you the top 10 ways how people get in their own way. Yeah, so you can learn a lot. Also very important, and this is another very, very important aspect here, is when it comes to the topic of failure and doing mistakes, is eventually to find the benefit in a bad experience. Yeah, to find a benefit in the bad experience, or in other words, to find the positive thing in a bad experience. That's tough, right? I mean, we all experience bad stuff and bad things, and this is also a very emotional topic, you know. I mean, there are so many different things happening in our life, and everybody of us has experienced really, really, really bad things, tough things, crazy things, and some of us, or most of us, were devastated by these events. And but from my experience, I can tell you that this is really true. You have to have the ability to find the benefit, the good thing. This is not something you have. Some people have that ability, but the good news is, if you don't have that ability, you can develop that ability to look for the benefit in a bad experience, or as I always say, look for the gold. Look for the gold. There's always something to look for the gold in anything what is happening in any experience. Look for the gold. And if you cannot see the gold, then you have to keep looking. It is there. You have to keep looking. Don't give up. Yeah, don't shortcut. Don't let your own impatience overrule and overrun you. The gold is there. You just have to keep looking. If you haven't found it, my friend, I tell you, we haven't looked properly. I tell you, this is true from my own experience. I could actually name a few examples from my own experience. I can give you one example very quickly. It is a long time ago, about 16 years now, when I lived in Germany at the time. And I lived together with my ex-girlfriend. Now it's ex-girlfriend, obviously. So we separated. And that was, I think, the most tough experience up till then in my entire life. I was very young. I think I was like 25 years old. So nevertheless, so when we separated, that was the worst day in my life. And I thought, that's it. Yeah, I will never find another girl, and you know, all this stuff you're going through. And I was literally going through hell and this and that. So it was really the worst situation, and it took me many months to get over it. But eventually, because of that situation, I started to apply in the United States. You know, because of different circumstances, I decided to move to the United States again. And eventually I got the job there and everything worked out, and I had the time of my life in Southern California, in San Diego, when I arrived eventually in 2003 in San Diego. I had the time of my life. So in retrospective, if we would have not separated, as a matter of fact, she broke up with me. So you know the story now. Yeah, I can be honest. So yeah, she broke up with me. So if she would have broke up with me, I don't know what would have happened. I mean, but she broke up. It was a disaster emotionally, and I thought that's the end of the world. But you know, the good thing was I kept moving. I applied for the United States. I got my job, and I was very happy at the end. In retrospective, like in hindsight, it was the best thing what could happen to me. The best thing, and now it sounds crazy, but in hindsight, it was the best thing what could happen to me. This is only one. I have a few other examples, but I will not talk about them here now. I just wanted to give you an example from my own experience. So to find the benefit in a bad experience. There are also many other authors who are writing about this, you know. I think especially Napoleon Hill in his book, The Law of Success and Think and Grow Rich, which are books I will also talk about in the future. So get ready, stick around. What else? A lot of failure goes into success. Ah, I like that quote here. There is a funny quote, actually, I also found in the book. It goes like this. Never ask what's in a hot dog while you are eating one. Never ask what's in a hot dog while you're eating one. Why not? Yeah, because actually you don't want to know. Yeah, because if you would know, I think you probably throw that thing away immediately, you know. Because you really don't want to know what is inside a hot dog, right? So it's the same with success, you know. People only look, only see the success, the glamour and this and that. But I don't really know. They have no clue mostly what really went inside to success. That's why this quote, a lot of failure goes into success. But this is not what you see. You only see the end result, the glamour and this and that. And the success and wow and all, and you get, you know, you start to get envious and jealous and then or whatever, and or maybe not, you know, and then you admire these people, and then but you don't know what they went through. You really, really don't know. So never ask what's in a hot dog while you're eating one. Yeah, keep that in mind. It's a funny quote, actually. The good thing with these reviews, you know, I read these books a while ago, many months ago. And, you know, it forces me, of course, to go through the books again, and I remember and I repeat, and then I find some quotes here and there. It's really, really, for me, also a good exercise to repeat certain things, which is actually very important. I must say, this book actually deserves to be read at least twice or three times, you know, with actually any book of John Maxwell. Success really is the ability to follow through until the breakthrough. So I'm gonna repeat that one, because it's how I find very, very important and crucial. Success really is the ability to follow through. That's what success is. Like failure is never an event, what we learned earlier, what I talked about earlier. Success is not an event, it's also a process, and it is really the ability to follow through until you break through. And when there is no breakthrough, then obviously it's not a success. So people say, so what if I don't break through? What if I quit? Yeah, if you quit, if you decide to quit, of course you failed, right? But success really is the ability to follow through. So this is a process, and that's the thing to understand, you know. It's not an event, it's success is a process, you know, until you break through. And of course it's not going to be a walk in the park, probably. But this is another topic for next time. So I think I'm already through with my review here. I hope I could give you some interesting bait here. I hope you're a little bit hungry now. I hope you're going and gonna check out this book. It's really worthwhile reading. I highly recommend it. You know, everything I talk about, I only highly recommend here. Nice book, really great book to read. And then I want to close with a quote, a last quote I also found in the book, of course. It's a nice one, and it really resembles the whole topic of failure and success and mistakes, what we have talked about earlier. And it goes like this. Two men looked from prison bars. One saw mud and one saw stars. Two men looked from prison bars. One saw mud and one saw stars. You know, that's, again, this is the attitude you take, you know. It's up to you what kind of perspective you take in life, what kind of what is your point of view. You want to see the mud, you see the mud. You want to see the stars, you are able to see the stars. It's really up to you. Or in other words, Failure or success, it's up to you. You decide if you are a success or a failure. You. Not other people, not circumstances or other events. This is what we have to learn. We have to learn to accept and to understand and to realize that only we are in charge and therefore we are responsible. We want to understand and learn that we have the ability to respond appropriately to all circumstances, events and people. It is in our power to decide if we are a failure or if we eventually become a success. Thanks for watching. I hope you liked this video. Please post your comments down below. I would like to get feedback from you, of course, also about my presentation style and everything. I appreciate any feedback. Please like the video, please share the video, and I'm gonna see you next time. Bye bye.